Hello everyone and welcome. I am Mohammed Kara, LibreOffice developer from Turkey. I will talk about what we have done to modernize the customized dialogue during the summer, and talk about the current status and plans for the future. Let me talk a little about myself first. In 2001, a friend told me that there is something called Linux, because and it was cool because not everyone can use it, so we would be special, and we started using it. Then Pardus project, a Debian-based distro, started in Turkey. And I started contributing it. It was using KDE desktop environment. I also contributed to Ubuntu through Launchpad, mostly localization. Then at some point, KDE switched to something called Plasma. I don't know if I am pronouncing it right, because at that point I stopped using it and switched to GNOME. And ever since then I have been using GNOME and contributing through Dynamodlize, localizing it. And since 2016 I have been contributing to LibreOffice. Now the customized dialogue, you can open the customized dialogue through tools and customize menu. There are several tabs in the dialog: toolbars, menus, context menus, keyboard, and events. It allows you to customize different aspects of LibreOffice based on your needs. In the past, there were many ways to customize LibreOffice in this dialog. It could be called feature complete, but it was not very useful. There were accessibility issues. It wasn't intuitive and straightforward, and there was no way to search for what you were looking for, and there were also some bugs. Let me show you what it looked like. In the past, you see it provided everything you need to configure and customize LibreOffice, but it was a little outdated. For example, you can't find what you are looking for. If you want to add something to a toolbar, a new button, you click the add button, a new dialog opens, and you have to go through all of them to find what you are looking for. So design team suggested that it needed some modernization to make it more usable, fully accessible, intuitive, and eliminate some underlying bugs. Let me tell you about the process, how we went through modernizing this. The initial proposal was by Heiko from the design team. It was beautiful, I think. I thought it is beautiful, and I should make this happen when I saw the design. It looked good to me, but everyone didn't agree on this, especially the tree structure on the left was criticized because it would cause some accessibility issues, and it also wouldn't fit into the GSOC timeline because it was complicated. So after some discussions and iterations by the design team and inputs from users, we agreed on this design, which is more, a little more conservative, and a little look like the old one, old design. But we kept the good parts like the search feature, and you will no longer have to click a button to add a button, click a button, open another dialog, and try to find what you are looking for. Everything is on the same dialog. You can easily find what you are looking for and easily add to a toolbar or menu. Then I applied GSOC with this proposal, and after 3 months of work and about 21 patches, we could only modernize 3 tabs and improved one of them. The keyboard tab got a search feature, and menus, toolbars, and context menu tabs were modernized. It wasn't complete at all. There were still some tabs not modernized and some missing features, but time was up. So at the end of the GSOC, this is what it looked like, the customized dialog. It got the search feature. It allows you to search as you type. It filters the entries in the box on the left, and the selected entry has the description. You can easily find what you are looking for and add to the toolbar or menu. But it wasn't complete, as I said, so I continued my work after GSOC, tried to add some missing bits and eliminate some bugs, fix some bugs. And this is how it looks like now. We did some improvements after GSOC. It looks better now. It is last time I tested, it was accessible. I tested with Orca. Everything was all accelerators were there and relations were set. This is how it looks like, but our work is not finished, and we will continue by modernizing the last 2 tabs, keyboard and the events tab. Add the missing bits on the already modernized tabs. For example, menus, toolbars, and context menus tab don't have a customized button, extra customized button to customize for rename the selected toolbar or menu. And we will also try to fix current bugs and arising bugs in the future. I have encountered some hardships during this work. I think most important ones are these. The code base was tightly coupled and undocumented. Most of the code was on a huge file. It was very hard to read. And there were some variables and class members sharing the same name in different classes in the same file. It was very hard. So the first thing I did was separating that into smaller pieces and trying to document as the parts I understand. And it was hard to reach consensus on designs because there are many different perspectives. both in the design team and the users. When it is in the design team, it is easier, but when users are involved, it gets harder. There is a dilemma here. If we don't interact with the users, we don't know what they need or what will they be happy with. And if we include them in the process, it gets very hard to reach a consensus. It is hard to assess the current situation because of similar reasons. And we need to keep the already happy users happy while making the changes. For example, in the dialogue, you had to open another dialogue and go through all of the items to find what you are looking for and click add to add the button. We changed it, brought it to the main dialogue and put a search feature, but a user complained about she could no longer see the description of the already added items, and we had to convince her this is a better approach. If you don't like what you see in the already in the design or what you see on the current dialogue, you are free to report bugs. It is always welcome. Bug reports are welcome. You can also send patches. I am looking forward to more patches from contributors. If you send a patch, just add me as a reviewer on Gerrit, and I'll try to work with you. And before finishing, I think I would like to mention someone I think who deserves a mention. I would like to mention Mustafa Akgül, who was called father of the internet in Turkey, and he was protector and guardian of the free software community in Turkey. He passed away recently, and we hope we can continue what he started. Thank you all for listening and supporting LibreOffice. Any questions?
In addition, one of the issues why things went into trouble was the feature that you can save the UI in a document. You can store the layout of a menu or toolbar in every document specifically. It is a function that I absolutely do not understand, and my proposal kicked it out. So people sharp, we can actually, no chance, we cannot remove it. We have to be very carefully with functions that we implement for only a few users, because in the end we have to keep it alive over decades afterwards. That's my problem here.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks for the input. I agree with you on that. That was...
Maybe you have to repeat for the microphone.
That was... yeah. The thing was... there was a feature, the design team, at least one member of the design team, thought was not useful and not logical, so it should be removed. And the initial proposal was removing that, and many people objected, said it shouldn't be removed because they were using it. So that was an example of hardships we encountered during the process. Thank you.